Coming up, we look at how anyone can automate time-intensive common tasks that you do day in and day out in Microsoft Teams. Now, we're going to show you how you already have everything that you need to do this, including the access to pre-built templates to quickly get you started, and how you can even progress to building your own mobile apps for your teams with a simple point-and-click approach, all without writing a single line of code. And here to show us how, I'm joined once again by Aya Tange from Microsoft Teams. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me back on the show, Jeremy.
Thank you. So what we're going to show today is really powerful. For anyone who's using Microsoft Teams, you can really use the latest code-free technology integrated in Microsoft Teams to really transform your day-to-day work.
Right. And it's really powerful and ultimately saves you time. Most people know Microsoft Teams as the hub for teamwork, where you have your chats, meetings, calls, applications in a single and secure location. But what I love most is actually being able to streamline and even automate the things that I do on a regular basis, all within the context of Teams.
Right, and there's always these things that you come across and you think, wouldn't it just be better or easier if there was a way to do that specific task that I do all the time in a more automated way?
Right. And another good example is we all probably have to go through that approval process, or we might be that key stakeholder that needs to give that final approval. Mm-hmm. So let me show you what we can do here.
Okay.
So I'm in Microsoft Teams here, and you can see all the approvals that I've received, as well as those that I have sent, and also all of my history. But we're taking this a step further, and you can actually now receive alerts in chat and directly approve in the chat. So let's show this, Jeremy. Do you mind uploading a document? And let's see how this works.
Sure, let me try this. So I'm here in my Teams channel for approvals in this case, for partner services. And I've got a file I want to upload here to make sure that you can approve it.
Right.
So when I go in, I'm going to select this one here. I'll click open. And that's just going to upload the document then to this file's location. And then once that's done, that will actually be submitted for your approval.
Right. I can just see the approval right here because my Flowbot has alerted me. Mm-hmm. And now I can look at the link that you just sent me. But because we've been working together, I'm just going to go ahead and hit approve. And I'm going to say, this looks great. And hit submit.
Okay, so here I can see that your approval actually just came through.
Right, and so this saved a lot of time. All you had to do was upload the file, and then it showed up in my Teams, and I can approve directly from here. So you didn't have to go chase me down. But when I approve this, it also gives both me and you a formalized record of that approval. And this has all been automated. But the best part is, I built this myself code-free.
Okay, so then what's behind this? How are you getting all of this stuff to work?
Sure. So the back end here is Microsoft Flow. If you're new to Microsoft Flow, it's actually a visual way to define the steps and conditions within a process. So here, you can see my flow. My file share in Teams actually lives in SharePoint. So when you upload a file, the approval process kicks off. It creates that approval, and then I can either accept or deny with this built-in condition. And then from there, it'll inform the requester either way.
Okay, that looked really great, but we're going a little bit fast here. Why don't we explain how you'd start out with a simple flow? Because I know you're pretty fluent with that.
Sure.
So why don't we build one from scratch?
Of course. So I'm back in Teams here in my customer support team under external requests. And I want to add a flow here. And I can easily do that by just clicking on the plus tab here and installing it and pressing save. You may be prompted to sign in. If so, you can do that. Here, I can actually create one from scratch or create one from a template. And you can see we have a ton of templates here. I can access all of this within Teams. But there's also a website that you can look at, and there's a complete set of templates here as well. So now, because most of my coworkers and I live in Teams, we often miss some emails. So one of the templates that I've used in the past is actually being able to be notified when an email comes in. So here is the flow that I'm talking about. So one tip here, flow is tied to your identity or your user account. And so this makes it so that you can only hook up to things that you have permission to.
Which makes sense. It's a kind of a security control. You don't want to have to be able to flow all my emails, for example, into the team.
Right. And don't worry, Jeremy, I can't steal your email through this flow. So the typical scenario here is actually if you're a sales support team and you have a shared inbox with customer inquiries coming in, let's say at info@yourdomain.com. Mm-hmm. And so instead of actually having to leave the team's experience, continuously have to check that inbox, you can use this pre-built template in Flow, and you can actually post the message into Teams when the email arrives.
Right, so, this is great for a shared mailbox that a lot of people have access to.
Exactly. So let me show you how this works. You can see here my inbox has already been pre-configured, but I can also select a specific folder that may be receiving requests. I can also do other things such as include attachments. Then I can go down into this condition here, and you can see the default is that everything in the email will actually flow into Teams. But I can decide what team it goes into, what specific channel, as well as what the message is actually going to say. So in this case, I want to make sure that my team knows that it's an external request and very important. Mm-hmm. So I've written in here external request. I then can decide what from the email I want to pull in. So I obviously want to know who it's from, the subject line, as well as the body of the email. But I can also add other dynamic content here if you wish. So I'm going to go ahead and save this flow. And I can also test it right here. But because you're with me, let's do this in real time. So Jeremy, do you mind sending me an email and we can see how this works?
All right. And so I've got an email here that I'm ready to send. I'll click send. And that will go into that mailbox.
So I can see the email request just came through. And I can see it says external request, your email address, your subject line, and all the content of your email, all within chat.
The great thing is that all this was achieved without a single line of code, so it's a nice example.
Right, so this is something that anyone on your team can really do, but there is so much more you can do with Flow. As you can see, we already have requests coming through, and in this case, these are customers asking for estimates on flooring jobs. Now as a team, we can discuss who's gonna take the job and how we're gonna respond. So let's say I'm gonna take this one, and I will let my team know that I am. But wouldn't it be great if I could actually contact you, Jeremy, if you weren't sitting next to me, and get all the details and actually set up an appointment for me to actually come out and do the estimates on your house?
Okay, so how would you go about doing that?
This is a great way of actually using Power Apps and another example of integrating processes into Microsoft Teams. So let me show you how this works within Microsoft Teams, but you can also access your Power App on your phone. And again, I've built this without any coding, and I'll show you that in a little bit.
All right, sounds good. Let's see it.
Great. So I'm going to add your information, Jeremy, just by clicking on the plus button. And to save time, it's already been filled in. So I'm going to go ahead and save the job.
All right, so is this a Power App then? How did you get this to appear in your Teams channel?
Right, so once we actually built the Power App, it's just like any other tab in Teams. Just like we did in Flow, you can click on the plus button here and add your Power App, and then select the specific app that you're looking for. In my case, it's the cost estimator. One of the coolest aspects of Power Apps is that once you've actually built this out and published it, you can have them run on a mobile device by any user in your organization.
Okay, so we've seen it now in the context of Microsoft Teams, but how would I get that app to run on your phone?
Sure. So users just need to go to the App Store or their marketplace and install Power Apps. Mm-hmm. Then they would have to sign in with their Microsoft 365 account, and then they will see all the apps that are shared with them. If there's one that they use on a regular basis, in this case, it'd be my cost estimator app, I could even pin this to the home screen so that I have easy access to it all the time.
It's great because it just is like any other app on the phone, but what's next?
So let's pick up where we left off in Teams. So I'm going to click your name, Jeremy, and let's say I'm actually at your house now and I'm ready to begin the estimate. Mm-hmm. You want to do something in your kitchen. It's 20 by 20, and now it'll calculate the square footage. So now it's time to select the flooring. This is the fun part. What kind of hardwood would you like?
Of these options, I think I like the natural hickory.
Perfect. So we'll give you that. And now I'm going to add a photo of the current floor and review my estimate. So now I'm going to sign and submit estimate. Great. And now all this information is going to go to you as the customer, as well as my team.
All right, so that looked like a pretty advanced app, but how do you go about building that?
So just to make it clear, I'm not a developer, and I actually used a template in Power Apps to create all this. So I'll show you how I did this. I'm going to go to my cost estimator app. And this is really very much like building a PowerPoint. So it's first going to ask me, does it want it to be a tablet format or a phone format? I'm going to choose phone today. So now we're going to start building this out. So in the app itself, I'm going to click into cost estimator. And you can see that this is really just a simple text box with the properties on the right-hand side.
Right.
Then I'm going to go into tree view. And here I'll show you a few aspects that we saw in my app just now. Mm-hmm. So I'm first going to go to room page. This is where I wrote kitchen in 20 by 20. Then I'm going to go to finish estimate page. This is where I signed. And at the top, I'm going to go to open jobs page. And this is where all my customer information is. Then in the top right-hand corner, I'm going to click the play button, and you'll see exactly what this looks like. But what I love about PowerApps is it actually gives me dummy data so I can really see how this works.
This is really great because as a former web developer, I can reverse engineer this. And the nice thing is I've got the scaffolding. I've got some dummy data in this case. How would I, though, make this app my own app with my own data in it?
So that's what Make My Own App does. It actually allows you to customize the data that's behind the application. So first it asks me where my data is stored. And my data is stored in OneDrive for Business. This is where my Excel tables and images are stored. So let's jump into OneDrive. Just to save time, I've actually already navigated into the Power Apps folder and into my Cost Estimator app. And here is my data Excel sheet. And this is what's actually populating the application and where all the new data will be stored. And you can see the most recent information about you, Jeremy, is right here. So I can also modify data directly from here as well. So let's say Bobby's name is spelled incorrectly, and we want to change it to Steinberg. So I'll make that change. And if we go back to our Power Apps in Teams, you can see that change that I just made.
And one of the nice things about this is it's just using OneDrive behind it. So anytime that you want to say go back in time, if you want to undelete or change Bobby's name back to Stein, it's just a version change in that file. And you can also grant things like read-write permissions to just the users of the app. And it's all just back-ended by Excel. So you've shown us some really great use cases. These are technologies really integrated with Microsoft Teams. But we can also build more sophisticated business process automation, and we can do even more with our app experiences, right?
Right. So once you actually take that step and try these code-free approaches for yourself, you'll see how accessible these environments are.
Right. And there's really a lot of opportunity then for users to really streamline the business processes they work with every single day and do that even further by automating the things with Microsoft Flow and using things like Power Apps.
Right. In fact, the example that I just gave you was inspired by a dispatcher at the glass repair company called Autoglass. This dispatcher built his first app to automate the process that their field technicians use to update their job status while repairing chipped or broken glass on cars. He taught himself Power Apps and then built and deployed his first app all within 1 month. And this is really just scratching the surface. You can even integrate AI and machine learning with cognitive services for speech, vision, text, sentiment, and much more. So really, the sky is the limit.
And this is really great because it could be for a small business. Maybe you have 10 or 20 employees, or it could be a large organization with 20,000 employees.
Right, and all of these workflows are easy to create and manage within Teams to increase your efficiency.
Really good stuff. So thanks for joining us today, Aya. But what's a good way for folks watching to learn more?
Sure, so first, try it out. Start with those pre-built templates and you can modify them and then graduate to building things from scratch. And there are a lot of tutorials, so you can find out more at the link shown below. But the best way is to really just kick those tires and experiment like I did.
Really great stuff. So hopefully everyone watching will be inspired enough to help improve general aspects of their day-to-day workflows using Microsoft Flow and Power Apps for themselves. Of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Microsoft, and we'll see you next time.